Welcome to this new video. If you've seen my content before, you know that I normally do drawing and painting tutorials where I try to give art advice and tips. But today, I wanted to do something a little bit different, something a little bit more fun. I'm going to collaborate with my 9-year-old daughter, Ella, here.
Hi.
And we're gonna do a painting of her mother, my wife, and Ella's gonna start it completely from scratch and take it halfway, and then halfway through the video, I'm gonna jump in and take it from there and see what we can do with it. But the one thing is, I can't...
change it.
I can't change anything. I can't move anything Ella sets up. I'm just gonna...
he has to paint right over it. Can't change anything.
Paint right over it, can't change anything. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's do this.
Today I'm going to be painting my mom. I'm going to try as hard as I can to do the best of painting. She doesn't even look close to being my mom. Do we have any blue? I guess I could do this, but I think I need more black, but okay, we can, because her hair is black and I can't fit this because doesn't look like much, but it's going to look way better at the end. My picture looks like a it looks like a dog, basically, except no ears. Smaller brush to do her eyes. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this, but we'll try this. So take some black and dot that in there. Do it. I got some black on my hand, but still, I should wait till this dries actually. Got a black dot in the middle of her eye, which I think you're supposed to, right? They just look weird and too close to each other, but next, we're gonna try the nose, which is gonna be even worse. But I don't think it's going to be even worse because like, this is way better. She looks like a pig. Oh my gosh, I don't think I can fix that at all. It just looks weird. I think her only thing that looks good is her hair. So now we're gonna color. We need her a mouth. We need a mouth, of course we need a mouth. We'll do this, okay. The lips are my favorite part. Like, just look at that. I need more tan because this is not working out for me. I'm going to paint around her lips carefully. Do, do, do. Terrifying. No! I just got paint, water paint on my leg. That's just great. No. Oh no, how am I gonna build the nose? She's gonna be noseless. Boop. I'll try this. Hopefully this will work. Okay, this is her nose. We're just gonna leave it like that. Something just creeping me out right here. I'm just gonna call my dad in and see what he's up to. Dad!
Hey, that's awesome.
No, that's
that is awesome.
No, that's horrible. Look at the camera.
What?
It looks horrible.
No, you don't think
you're
that
lying.
Looks like, no, I think it looks awesome.
You're lying.
You saved me a ton of time by doing this, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate it.
Yeah, you're going to have to
I'm gonna keep
that.
Working on it. I'm gonna have to keep,
it
I don't want.
It doesn't even look like her. Are you just saying that because I'm your daughter?
No. This is awesome, are you kidding me? I love it, we're gonna let it dry, and I'm gonna come back and paint on it.
Say in the comments if you think I
definitely leave a comment for Ella here.
No, if I did good.
Ella did awesome, let her know in the comments down below, and let's also let her know that we want her in more videos because this has been so much fun, so thank you, Ella. I'm gonna let this dry, and I'll be back in just a second to keep painting.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, so I'm gonna jump into this. I love what Ella did, so I'm not gonna move anything here. I'm gonna leave the eyes where they are. I'm gonna leave the nose where it is, the mouth. Everything's gonna stay the same. I'm just gonna try to paint like I normally paint and see how far I can take this. So the one thing that Ella did here is she put the nostril holes here. They're sort of off the nose. They're kind of on the cheeks. You know what I'll actually do is I'll bring the nostril. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna bring the nostril wing around those nostril holes. So it's gonna kind of widen to get around that structure. Grab some alizarin, some ivory black, and really put in those nostril holes again. I can see where she had them under there. I'm just gonna paint right back over them. Now we're gonna get into the eyes. She didn't really paint eyelids. I'm gonna hint them a little bit, and then I'm gonna focus on making those eyeballs look nice and round and real underneath those eyelids. So let's see what happens. Grab some titanium white here, a little ivory black to get that eye color, a little bit of flesh tone. Something that'll tuck these eyeballs back into the eye socket a little more is having the eyelid, which we're gonna paint, cast a bit more of a shadow, and those eyelashes casting a shadow on the eyeball will help set that eyeball back there in space a little bit more. So let's see if that helps settle them in the structure. Let's get that cast shadow over here like this. Grabbing some alizarin and ivory black. Put that pupil in right there. Right in the center, she's looking at us. She's looking at us very intensely. And then we're going to grab, well, let me make that a little bit better. And then we're gonna grab the titanium white. Ooh, look at that. A rather reflective eyeball. I wouldn't wanna wake up to this in the morning. All right, beautiful. Maybe I'll enter it into an art competition. I want to enter one that where you get like $1 million, because I feel like we might have a shot. You're gonna go to college, Ella. I could be wrong here. You might have a different opinion, but I'm pretty sure that Ella meant for the face to come here and there to be the chin right there, and that this is the neck. And I think that because we have that angle change from here to here. Just the brushwork that she used really signifies neck to me. All right, let's mix up a shadow value here and color alizarin cat orange, raw umber. And let's just kind of try to put in this shadow here. Let's really work on the fullness of the head. Let's sell this. Let's make it real. Let's make it 3D. We're gonna do it. We're gonna come around here, light from above. Let's get a little darker. So we go down this side plane here, light just bathing this beautiful cheek. Ella really went for that chroma on there. I don't know how she did that. It looks like cad red and she didn't have, oh, I guess she did. She had a different palette than me. She had that more intense red. Ah, we're losing some of that. Buy some red, Scott. Shopping list. Alexa, put red on the shopping list.
I've added red to your shopping list.
Thank you. I'm about to encounter and stare dead in the eyes one of the biggest challenges in all of painting when it comes to painting a portrait of a female. How do you make the light fall off down their face? They get darker so that the light appears to be dropping off without making it look like they have a beard. You gotta drive right up to the edge of beardiness. And right when you're about to make impact, color-wise, with beardiness, you turn left. You turn away from the beardiness. So notice, I went right up to the edge. I was like right on the edge of beardiness. I had that gray in there. It was looking like stubble. And then I went back towards the orange. I went back towards the chroma and we pulled it left. Pulled it out of beardiness. That's how you do it. We just got the chin left. The chin's a joke. The chin's the easiest thing. It doesn't even matter anymore. I can do this with one eye closed. I don't even have to look at it. All right, I'm gonna leave this right here and we're gonna go get Ella now. She hasn't seen this since she left it off and we're gonna see what her reaction is. I'll be right back.
Oh. Wow. I'm so freaky. Come here. Close your eyes.
Okay.
Cover them with your hand. And then look at that instantly. Open your eyes. It's just like, it just.
It does hit you in a certain way. Would you do it again?
Yeah.
All right.
If it was you, I would do it.
Oh, you want to do a painting? She wants to do a painting of me. Do you want to? No, nobody wants to see that. No one.
I want to do it. Because I could draw the hat really
quickly. You guys have seen, oh, that's a good idea. The hat is a cool thing. But nobody wants to see this. You guys see it enough. What?
Instead of a person.
She is so smart. So what Ella just told me was, if you want to see us paint anything together like this, leave it in the comments, make a suggestion, and we'll try to do it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you want
to see- Don't forget to subscribe.
Subscribe.
And hit the little bell.
Hit the little bell and what else?
Don't forget to share with your family or your friends.
Share with your family and friends if you want to see more videos like this. And if you want to see Ella and I collaborate again, put in the comments down below something you'd like to see us paint together and we'll get to it. We're ready. Are you ready?
Yep.
Thanks for watching. See you soon. Welcome to this new video. Today, my 9-year-old daughter,
Ella.
Stop. All right.
Okay, just end this thing and we'll do a real one.
Well, okay. Hey, what are you doing with your?
I don't know. No, end this video.